was so crazy. And me and my mommy was like, what the fuck? He had 30,000 views, 80,000, he had 80,000 likes.
Yeah, he was fired, blah, blah. Yeah, damn.
So we was already kind of known for that. So then when me and my baby mama separated and stuff like that, and then I, you know, went and hiding and all that, and then popped out with this motherfucking character. Oh, you know, the streets was talking like a motherfucking bitch.
Right.
And then, everybody was talking. Everybody had something to say. My kid, you know, because this was 5 years ago. No, please.
Bro, you gotta go back to this on your Facebook, bro. Please. I know, like, you bossed up, but goddamn, but like, what the fuck? Like, it's just so funny. Just
but see, Camlo, you go with that. So the thing is, you can't tell me about my movie. My life is a movie, as a stupid bitch, I became a character. So I went from Tina Keisha to ghetto ratchet bitch, hood bitch, still, you know, still saying, but then I formed the super bitch. You know, because I went to coming up.
Y'all, look, it's Dion.
Yeah, that's me. But anyway, I went to coming up and stuff like that, so I wanted to show social media, like, my change and my growth. That was when I first started. So I got booked. That was one of my first bookings in Baltimore. But yeah, that was one of my first bookings in Baltimore.
Don't y'all never speak about Warren. He been there the whole way.
That was so long. All that so old.
It's old.
But yeah, so that's kind of how I did it. So I always just... But then I formulated the super bitch. I went from the plants to a track piece to all of this to, you know, the wigs. I remember I said I never wear makeup. Nico... Okay, I never told the story. Nico, the reason I had to wear makeup. Because I always told everybody the only way I'm gonna do makeup if I do that chick say do that makeup. I had to do it. So Miko, I had to do it. And I loved it. I say, okay, well, it's cool. This is a part of my involvement. You know, I was all on the billboards and shit like that with the makeup and shit like that. So it was the transformation for super. It was another part of my story. So I just kept going with it. And, you know, it's lit. I love it. You know, I fuck with the girls. A lot of people fuck with me. I love a lot of people. Like, you know, I don't tell y'all all my business. I don't celebrity drop. I don't name drop. I don't stand talk about everybody who I'm on the phone with. I don't tell you who my lawyer is, who my doctor is, who my motherfucking group of dentists is. I don't tell you bitches none of my shit. But I know a lot. I know the business, bitch. And I'm very blessed. You know what I'm saying? And it's because a lot of these people saw my growth and stuff like that. And I'm well respected. And people know what time. You know, when I walk in any building, bitch, everybody know what time it is. I do. I can take care of myself. I can carry my weight, baby. Straight up. So, you know, but I used to be just... I remember what was so crazy. I did an interview with Keisha Cole's sister, nephew, on her radio station. And this was years going on. Man, this is when I had a motherfucking Hyundai. I think it was like a 2001. You know, the old Hyundai. Probably 2008. I don't know. Bitch, the windows wouldn't roll up. Camlo, get that video with the windows with me in the car with Dawn. And I had drove all the way to Atlanta. And I did the interview. Let me tell y'all what was so crazy. This is the truth. I get emotional when I tell this story. I only told this story once. And it was me and Warren. And it was two dudes who did the interview that we met. A couple. Very successful. They just pulled up in a what? Man, a motherfucker pulled up in a motherfucker spaceship on the ass. But instead of being a hater, instead of being one was jealous, we were so inspired and just motivated by this before we moved to Atlanta. And I told Warren I was embarrassed to pull up my car. I said, man, you know what? I don't give a fuck. I'm a star. And when I say that, we put up in the parking lot. I said, I'm about to park my shit at the front motherfucking door. I said, I'm the motherfucking star. I always told myself that. I said, bitch, I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck, you know, because we all met before, and then we was all going into the interview. I said, I don't give a fuck, bitch. I'm just starting to embarrass my shit. It is what it is. I'm the fucking school. Keisha Cole in hell. I don't fuck with this bitch. So, and that's what it was. They're still my friends today, but they're not together no more. But, and no tea, no shade. I'm very, 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 very well assessed. Me and one, we had many calls. So, you know, blessed up. And, I was inspired by it. They had a cleaning business, though. That's what that interview was about. They cleaned the business and stuff. It was so
I thought she didn't want to be a Jason Coach. What's he?
would know what to do. Cause if I was to get a 9-to-5 now, I'd be managing and running this shit. Cause now, cause you know my qualifications. So you know, in financial department and everything else. So it wouldn't be, you know, it'd be okay. I definitely wouldn't make what I'd be making now, but I'd make it. But I wouldn't want to do that. But so, but a job 9-to-5. But if I was ever to go to a 9-to-5, I would have a great position because I know how to work hard for it. I know how to execute. So I know all about PR and marketing. I know a lot about just the main keys of businesses and running businesses, successful businesses. And I have a successful track record and a substantial track record to get me whatever job I want to get. No T, no chain. If I want to get a job in any firm, any business.
Yeah, my shit done froze up.
Because, you know, I've been doing this shit. So, yeah.
I was in the queue five times, and I didn't see a bitch in the queue.
Oh, that's what I was talking about was more important than you in the queue.